What's bracking, guys? Welcome to another episode of my Everton career mode. This is definitely a huge one here as we have this big fixture against Wolfsburg. And the reason why it's so big basically is so much is at stake. We could either win the group or we could just be completely knocked out of the competition in this group stage here, depending on that result between Lille and Krasnodar. But as you can see, you know, we've been going with the same lineup for a while now, especially with McCarthy being hurt, Besic sitting in there next to Gibson, of course, Selk, Lukaku up top, Barkley, Morales out wide, then the usual back line there. Definitely hope, you know, we can control that very good attack of Wolfsburg. As you can see, so much talent on their side. Definitely have to look out for the likes of De Bruyne, Schürrle, Vinicius, Dost. They're definitely going to cause problems for us, as well as Trosh and Rodriguez, of course, has been so good going down that wing. So we definitely have to keep an eye on him. Going to be testing the likes of Coleman and Morales a lot down that wing. But you'll see just off the kickoff here, trying to make something happen with Selk, but unfortunately nothing comes out of that. As you can see, they're playing some beautiful football here, some gorgeous stuff, really just keeping the ball so nicely, so tidy. There's Rodriguez is already pushing up down the wing, so play the ball back here to Luis Gustavo. Look at this flick on from Schürrle to Dost. Dost is going to beat this tank, and Howard does pretty poorly on that one. It is looks like there's a lot of precipitation there, but either way, Howard should be doing a lot better on that shot. And Dost, unfortunately, picks up a big goal for Wolfsburg for them to go up early. So much momentum is on their side, taking away some of the momentum, most likely from the Everton crowd, the Goodison Park crowd. But you see, try to come back off of the kickoff as the ball is being played down the flank from Lukaku to Coleman. Put the ball back in to Morales, to Besic, going to push up with Gibson. He's going to do a nice job. He always does a nice job going, playing that box-to-box role, essentially. But Barkley is going to send in a beautiful cross here to Selk, and Selk is in the perfect spot. Perfect cross, perfect finish there from Selk. This youngster has grown so tremendously facing a squad in his native Germany. Look at this cross from Barkley with his left foot, and look at that header. Great job from Selk to get in that spot. As you can see, just enough power on that to get over the keeper. As you can see, Selk has had two goals in EuroLeague, some pretty big goals as well too. But you'll see Wolfsburg is going to try to come back on the kickoff of the kickoff. Seems like this is where all the action was coming in this episode here. But you'll see Gustavo does a good job, just keeps the ball so well as we're trying to get the ball back. So we just need to put a lot of pressure on them, especially with our two strikers. Want them to help out a lot. As you can see, Lukaku dropped down tremendously. But a good ball here from De Bruyne. Looks like he may get a lucky deflection after winning the ball back, but thankfully it's cleared out by Jajelka there. As you can see, out here, out wide, Schürrle is going to play the ball back to his right foot and play it back here to Trosh. He's going to do a good job playing it back to Schürrle. Just this little nice little intricate play, keeping the ball here. It's a good job cutting in. He's going to play this ball to Varinha. He's going to take this shot. Deflection from distant, and it's going to fall to De Bruyne. He's going to finish that. A bit unlucky there, I'd have to say, but either way, that's a good worked goal from Wolfsburg. Of course, the German side is causing so much problems here already. De Bruyne with a very tidy finish there, but would have liked a little bit more from, you know, likes of Besic helping defend, in my opinion. But either way, this is going to be very tough here with that 2-1 lead from Wolfsburg. But you'll see again here, back again off kickoff. I do not know what it was about kickoff, but we'll see Barkley here with the ball. It's a good job getting down the wing as Trosh is going to miss that tackle. Barkley's going to come in, send this ball here to Morales. He's going to try to go up for it, and it looks like he's going to get a penalty shout there. We'll have to take a look at the replay to see if it really was, but either way, it's a good chance for us to equalize here. We definitely want to weather the storm. It's been such a crazy matchup. Be nice to just grab the goal and hold on to a draw, but I'm not sure what the penalty was exactly. Looks like by the camera it was called on Rodriguez, but I don't see much, to be honest. But we'll take it, and Bane's going to take this one. It's going to hit it to his right, to the right of the keeper. Very well taken as we do tie things up now. It's been definitely a very frustrating fixture so far, but we hope to be able to hold on to this lead. As you can see, very well taken from Baines, just what you expected from him. But De Bruyne is going to play the ball back here to Schürrle. He's going to do a good job, of course, running out the defense. He's been, you know, just really active all over the pitch, it seems like. See some good little intricate play here. Good from Perisic. He's going to try to play the ball across. It's going to fall to Schürrle. Of course, distant, got a little bit of a deflection on it, but unfortunately, it just fell right to Schürrle. So a bit unlucky for on his part, but either way, it's so frustrating. The defense just has not been good enough against this side, and I almost was expecting it, to be honest, because it's such a good squad. But you'll see the ball's going to be played back here. Rodri is going to push down. Selke is going to take him down, it looks like. Looks like he was holding him outside of the box and grabbed the inside of his jersey there while Rodriguez is pushing into the box. Definitely a bit frustrating to get those calls because it just always seems to happen. We're just trying to tug them outside of the box to try to push them off the ball, but they grab jersey, they get tugged down in the box, and it's just pretty frustrating. But you'll see Schürrle takes it, and Tim Howard maybe could have gotten a foot on that, but he guesses wrong as Schürrle just went right down the middle. Very poor taken, I have to say, but it did catch Tim Howard off guard there as we are down 4-2. This is absolutely huge because depending on the result of that Cross the Door Lille game, we could be sent out of the Europa League. But we'll see the ball's going to be played out wide here for Baines. So we're going all out attack. Just need to push numbers. At least grab a goal back would be nice. So the ball's going to be played back to Coleman. And we'll see Coleman's going to play it back here to us, who came on as a sub. Played here to Barkley. He's going to take a shot. It's going to hit off of the keeper. He's going to be tapped in by Lukaku. That's an absolutely huge goal for just the goal differential sense in the group stage. We just have to pray and hope, essentially, for a very tight matchup, a draw, or a very narrow win from Cross the Door or Lille. So either way, we do get away with this result. As you can see, Tim Howard was just hoping, wondering what was the result in the other matchup. But first, before we take a look at what occurred in the other matchup there, we're going to see Darren Gibson is going to be out for 4 weeks. So disappointing, as he's been really so good lately. We just had so many injuries in the midfield. You'll see we do narrowly escape thanks to that goal differential. I think we would have gotten knocked out by Cross the Door because they did beat us just recently in that home fixture. I think we might have tied with them. I don't remember the result, but either way, we do get away with one, and we will completely take it here. As you can see, we're going to get into this big match against Hull City at home. We're going to try to get our fans going after that very tough result against Wolfsburg here. So you're going to see we do have some chances. John Stones is going to step in for Sylvain Distin, and Osman is going to step in next to Besic in place of Darren Gibson there. As you can see, McCarthy is healthy enough to be on the bench, so that's big for him. We'll see his return in the next episode, guys, so be big there. We'll see a good ball played here. Good turn from Livermore, and it's going to be just a good save from Tim Howard. Nice reaction save on his part, but you can see Hull City has really been pushing up already, give us some problems here, but you'll see balls we played. Good job from Besic, taking advantage of a bit of a poor touch. Besic is now just going to push down the field, going to try to make something happen. Does a good job here. He's going to play the ball through to Barkley, who's going to get on this. He's going to beat his defender. Look at that little feint there. He's going to send this ball in to Lukaku. Ball's going to fall back to him on the volley. Great save, however, unfortunately, to keep things level. But we'll see ball played back here. Good ball from Besic. He's been so impressive, honestly. But we'll see Lukaku is going to run at the defense. Going to wait for the run of Seamus Coleman. And a good run from him. He's going to try to send this ball in, but it does get tipped away, that ball there. We'll see Morales is going to send this cross, and he's going to fall to Selke. Some great control there. He's going to try to take the shot. It's going to fall back to him. This time he's going to hit it through the defender's leg into the side netting. That's a huge goal from him. A little bit of luck maybe, but we will absolutely take that one there. As you can see, just a gorgeous finish either way from Selke, despite a bit of luck on his side. Something you have to have and take advantage quite frankly, if you want to be a quality team, in my opinion. But see, Bane's going to try to take this free kick. It's going to deflect out to Jajelka, who's going to settle this one. It's going to just smash this one. Just a gorgeous goal from Phil Jajelka, as he even deflects that ball into the net with his knees. But you see, he had to take this look at this replay again. What a rocket from Jajoka. Keeper nearly got a palm to that one, but either way, that's his tremendous hit from the center back with his first goal of the season. The spin on that was absolutely amazing there, as you can see the ball sent over here from Morales. The ball is going to fall back to Lukaku. A little bit of luck with the deflection. It's going to fall back to the Celtic. He's going to play the ball through to Bastich, who's going to score that. He definitely deserved it because he's been so good in all facets of the game since he's had to step in with all the injuries. Was a bit poor against Wolfsburg, I have to say, but that was a huge matchup, and I think, you know, a lot of young players would not do so well in those instances. But you'll see this ball played here to El Mohamedy, just on the side, try to clear this out. Very poor clearance. The ball's going to fall back to Abel Hernandez after another poor clearance, and he's going to finish that. Would have really liked to keep the clean sheet, but unfortunately we cannot do so there. Just have to be a lot more safer and just clear it out with B. And yeah, be your circle essentially is what it would be, but cannot do that. But we'll see. Stones makes up for it by stepping up here, doing a good job setting up this play here. Barkley's going to come down the wing, has tons of space, as you know. Holstein has been pushing up numbers, but we'll see. This ball is going to be sent to Kone. He's going to finish that first time. He came off the bench, was able to score right there. He's been scoring quite a bit for us lately, mainly off the bench, has had some stuff go his way. And I remember it was one of the Capital One Cup matches against a lower side, I believe it was Burton Albion. But either way, a huge win for our side. Need to get some confidence going back into the side after a very tough fixture against a very good Wolfsburg side regardless. But you'll see in the next episode, we face Stoke City, Newcastle United. Definitely think we need to grab points, 3 points at least against Stoke. And 1 point would be, you know, adequate against Newcastle away. They're a tough side at their place. But you'll see we're in a very good spot, as you can see some of the relegation ahead of side. But they're in second place right behind Chelsea with the game in hand. So I definitely hope you guys have enjoyed this episode. It's gonna be a big one next episode and the one after that with the transfer business coming up. So I hope you've enjoyed this, and I'll catch you guys later.